Let's find out what this week has in store for all of us. Let's have a chat about it. Hello, Stacy the Black Feather Intuitive here. Welcome to another weekly oracle reading for the week of January 25th. Hoping this week is finding you well. Let's call in all the archangels, ascended masters, highest guides, light beings, creature teachers, elementals, loved ones in spirit. Come on into this space to give us the clarity and guidance that we need to really understand what our purpose is this week in the grand cosmos. Getting all esoteric here. All right. If you like what you see here, feel free to like, subscribe, and click the bell on the YouTube, and stay tuned to the end of the video. I've got some exciting information to share with you, a couple of specials going on. All right. So I am using Barbara Moore's Wizard's Tarot today. This is a new deck that it's not new. It's been around for quite some time, but it's new to me, and I'm just loving it. So let's see what we've got going on. Interesting. Seven of Swords. This is a card of tested integrity. So what I'm hearing is this week, we really need to be paying attention to our honesty levels. How honest are we being with ourselves? Are we tapping into the individuals around us and feeling like what they're saying is not 100% of what is actually going on? Paying attention to the concept of truth. How is truth playing out and enacting in your life? I'm going to just take a picture or take a look at this card here and not show it to you for a minute, because what I'm seeing here is he's carrying a number of books, and each of these books on the spine has some kind of interesting, it looks like a dagger. And how interesting to me, it actually looks like syringes. It looks like shots. And given that we are going through this interesting pandemic and we are dealing with vaccinations, now, I'm not an anti-vaxxer by any means. If you are, love and light. I appreciate your stance on it, and I understand. But I do feel and have felt for a long time that around this pandemic, we don't know everything. There isn't a whole lot of truth, clear truth out there. There are a lot of different, you know, tidbits that we're hearing about, snippets that we're receiving. I'm feeling like this week, and this is because I'm seeing this sort of, they look like syringes to me. I'm feeling like this week there's going to be some hard truths coming out. Things that people maybe haven't been fully honest and above board with that are going to be coming to light. Now, I'm going to put that to the side because this is not a conspiracy theory channel here at all. Let's bring it into the regular as well. When I see these as daggers along the spines of the books, I'm feeling very much here the idea of you want to really pay attention to the information and the knowledge that you are taking in from other people, because, you know, daggers are a double-edged sword. Truth is a double-edged sword. Let's talk about that. Sometimes the truth hurts. Sometimes we don't want the truth in our own lives. Sometimes finding out that somebody has lied to us really is, I mean, it hits that betrayal button, and we feel like, oh my God, why did you do this to me? You're stabbing me in the heart, stabbing me in the back, twisting it. I'm feeling like there's a lot of energy here around truth in our own lives and paying attention to what we are not being honest with ourselves about, and paying attention to our intuition around interactions that we're having with people in our day to day, because it's the feeling. It's not, and I talk about this a lot, it's not always the words that are used, it's the feeling underneath that the words give you. So you kind of hear those words and you go, I think there's more to that than meets the eye, right? I think there's something else going on there. But oftentimes we dismiss that intuition. We say, no, that's not right, that's not true. Or we hear it and we go, I need to probe a little further, a little deeper. I need to ask some more questions here to kind of get to the heart of it and the truth of it. So I'm feeling like issues around knowledge and information either being given or received that you want to pay attention to. What is it that that is my truth in this moment? Am I being truthful with myself about what I'm seeing and what I'm experiencing? This is a lot of like, you know, he's going down, you know, a dark stairwell, and you know, we picture this going down into the library or going down into the laboratory, going down into something dark and dank, a basement. So what do we think about when we think about that? You know, a lot of secrets, a lot of creepiness, a lot of fear going on. Don't step into fear this week. This is not a reading about fear. This is a reading about empowerment and recognizing that, wait a second. If I'm feeling something a little bit is off, chances are it's off. And all I need to do is ask some probing questions to get to the heart of it. If I'm feeling off or uncomfortable about a choice that I'm making, I need to do a deep dive within, because there's some shadow work in there that's coming up that needs to be exposed and healed so that I can move forward making choices that are more informed, making decisions that are going to help me through the process, not hinder me. Any truth that is revealed this week is here for you. It's being revealed to help you get where you want to go. I always say knowledge is power, and knowledge is 50%. If we don't know something's broken, how can we fix it? How can we go about fixing it? We think everything is working fine. But if we understand, something's broken or something's a little bit off, Okay, well, good. I need to find out what it is so that I can tweak it, so that I can find some resolve. So again, this isn't this is, hey, let's pay attention. Truths revealed in our own lives so that we can rise above it. We can make healthier decisions, healthier choices. We can move forward in a positive light. We can get out of the basement. We can get out of the dark and into the light, you know, into that sunshine and that sunlight. So I'm also feeling really strongly, again, I want to just point out it is around knowledge and information. It can be through the written or communication, I want to say, you know, somebody reading something to you, somebody reading something off to you. The thing that keeps popping into my head is news, reading news articles or reading books. Reading things that are giving you information. And if it's making your spidey senses go off, don't shy away from that. Dive into it and see what it's trying to show you, because it is trying to reveal something so that you can have clarity around the situation. Clarity is always best. Interesting. All right, and this week we are using Colette Baron Reid's Spirit Animals Oracle Deck. Kind of an interesting juxtaposition here, seeing what the animals are gonna have to say about this Seven of Swords. Also, sevens are about manifestation. Swords is the realm of the mind, things, mental energy coming your way. So really feeling like it's about clearing away the cobwebs and the untruths so that you can get right to the heart of the matter and manifest what it is that you want in your life at this time. And Swan Spirit is coming in. Time for a deep dive. Oh my God, did I not say deep dive two or three times? I love this. You can't make this stuff up, I'm telling you. So time for a deep dive. This is indicating to me that this whole week, even though I'm seeing other people affecting you in this way, this is also about you going in for that deep dive and recognizing, hey, even though I've got some, you know, darker things that are coming my way, I can be the swan. I can move gracefully through it by doing the deep dive, going within and finding the heart of the issue, the crux of the matter. Because when I find it and I bring it to the surface and I bring it to light, A, it looks very different. Think about flora or fauna that you bring from, you know, up from the bottom of the ocean, or, you know, like if you're snorkeling, and of course you're not supposed to do this, but imagine like seaweed. Seaweed, when you're seeing it underwater, it's got such life, you know, there's space in between the branches and it's gorgeous, it's fanned out. When it washes to the shore, it's a tangled mess, right? So it's a shift in perspective. When you bring something to light, it gives you a different way to examine it. It looks different. It kind of takes the wind out of its sails a little bit, because it's no longer in its own environment of dark and dank. Now you're bringing it to light. I'm also feeling like here, when you are doing that deep dive, I think I said A, so now we've got B. When you bring it to the surface, you're also able to give it the kind of love and attention that it really needs and craves and deserves. And a lot of times this is what happens. I've been using a lot of analogy with children lately, so this is coming up. If you think about a child who, you know, something traumatic has happened to them or something that they're uncomfortable talking about has happened, and what you notice is they do things that are out of character. They behave in manners that are, you know, not like themselves, and you think to yourself, God, this child is usually really good. Why is this child doing this or this or this? Well, sometimes you find out a couple of days later they get sick, so they've been off, feeling off, and not having the right words to express that. Sometimes if something more traumatic has happened to them and they're really acting out, you seek outside assistance to kind of get to the heart of the matter. Once the heart of the matter is addressed, that child is able to heal from whatever that traumatic situation was, and they now have better coping strategies to be able to address, to be able to speak their truth, to say when they're hurting, to say when something has happened that's not right, and be able to move forward. So much comes out of that big reveal when you do a deep dive. So each and every one of us this week, the challenge is to do the deep dive on things that we might not want to see, those things that are in the dank basement. And the reason why we are doing the deep dive is so that we can bring light to the situation. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's evil and it's bad and it's wrong. Maybe if we judge it and deem it as evil and bad and wrong, what can we do about it? Adding light means that we can change it. We can move forward. We can take action steps to make a difference. We can do this in the microcosm of our life, and we can do this on a macrocosmic scale as well, more globally. So I'm really feeling like this week, it is about doing a deep dive within yourself, paying attention to these things that are coming up and saying, what part do I play? What part do I want to play in this? How can I shed my own light on this situation to be able to move forward in a way that I am comfortable with? I feel that I'm contributing in a positive way because I'm shining my light on this particular truth. And that's really what it's all about. Truth will set you free this week. Holy cannoli, peeps. Wow, like my brain is exploding. So can't wait to see what is gonna be transpiring this week. All right, and we have got yellow feather, willpower. And let's face it, when we are dealing with issues around truth, it does take willpower to do that deep dive and to look within. It does take willpower to be able to see a truth revealed that maybe isn't what you wanted. Maybe it doesn't make you super happy, but it takes willpower to be able to say, okay, it's not exactly the way I wanted it to be, but what can I do now? I can use my willpower to enact change. I can use my willpower to say, I'm going to accept that this is what it is, and now what do I want to do to improve the situation? What are my next steps? Maybe your next step is to just, you know, observe that for a while, sit in it for a while before you make any action steps. Maybe you're knowing right away what those action steps are that you're going to take. All of it is connected to willpower. What is the power at my core telling me I need to do? This isn't ego voice. This is power. This is soul power that we are accessing. And it's in the yellow, which is our solar plexus chakra. This is also the seat of our identity, which does involve the ego. But I'm encouraging you this week to not pay attention so much to the ego voice, paying more attention to that soul voice, the soul song, and enacting your willpower to be able to make that soul song heard, that soul song to be able to come out and shed light on the dark and the dank, and to bring to light that which is buried deep within so that we can heal it, we can add our special light to it, and move forward. All right, guys, that is our reading for the week. Sending everyone so much love. Kind of excited actually to see what this is going to reveal and how it's going to reveal in my life as well as our lives on a whole. So Yeah, keeping my eyes peeled for this one. So again, feel free to click the bell to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get all of these videos and all of the other videos that I do, Archangel stuff, wine and wisdom stuff. There's all sorts of fun goodies on this YouTube channel. Also, feel free to check out my website, theblackfeatherintuitive.com, my Facebook page and my Instagram, The Black Feather Intuitive. All sorts of fun things going on. Check out my Your Year In preview service. We've only got a few days left, guys. A few days left for you to tune in to what is in store for you this year. It's only $100 and it's an exclusive service and it's going away on January 31st is the last day and you won't be able to receive it after that. So check that out. Also, Angel Conversations. I had my first Angel Conversations workshop just a couple of days ago, and it was a smashing success. I'm so excited about it. If you like Archangels, if you're interested in learning about the Archangels, this is an opportunity to connect with them personally. I channel a particular Archangel every single month that is there to help guide us through a particular theme that we are dealing with based on these ever-changing times. There is an interactive portion where we get to answer all of your questions. It's a nice Q&A. So check it out on my website. It's called Angel Conversations. We are setting up to do this each month, this workshop, each and every month. So check that out. We'd love to see you there. There are some exclusive gifts for those who are in attendance and exclusive opportunities that you won't want to miss. But you got to do the workshop in order to find it out. All right, guys, take care. Have the most amazing week, and we will see you next time. Ciao.